Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. Today in content marketing, we'll discuss about the objectives. The objectives that are associated with your content marketing strategy. What are those objectives? How the objectives have to set and to be achieved? And the key elements that are associated in creating those objectives as far as your content marketing or content strategy is concerned. Now, how to set and achieve those objectives? We all know what are those objectives. You have certain objectives as far as your content marketing strategy or content marketing plan is concerned. Now, how to set those objectives and achieve those objectives? Research and analyze the industry and niche. Before you actually go on creating your objectives in content marketing, you need to do a thorough research and analysis of the industry and the niche to which you are going to create the content marketing plan or the strategy. This is an extremely important point. As long as you have complete knowledge of the industry and the niche for which you are going to create the content, you can actually go on creating the content that delivers results. Define and set goals. What are those goals that you can actually define and set as far as your content marketing plan and the strategy is concerned? You need to define the goals, you need to set the goals. Conduct persona research. The audience is extremely important for you. You need to actually go for the targeted audience. Who are your target audience, where they are located, what is the geography, what is the location, and what are the demographics that are associated with your audience, the targeted customers. Persona research helps you in that. Run content audit. The content you actually create, the content has to be audited, edited thoroughly. The content audit is extremely important one, because the content that you are actually writing is what it that engages with the end user at the end of the day. The content has to be completely audited. Then you formulate a strategy based on the complete analysis and the research that you have done. You have identified your customer, you have done the content audit, then you actually go on building the strategy. Track, measure, analyze, and report. Extremely important. The backbone of the content marketing is the analytics. The analytics play a very important role to help you understand how your content marketing plan is working, what is not working, and what are the tweaks, enhancements, or changes that you need to do as far as your content marketing plan is concerned. Track, measure, analyze the report so that you can take informed decisions based on the analytical information. Then go for the continuous improvement. Once you create the content marketing plan and you have the strategy, you are doing the content marketing, you are analyzing the reports from the analytics, you need to do certain changes, and that has to be a continuous process. That is never a one-time go. It has to be continuous and consistent. Keep on improving, keep on enhancing, keep on tweaking the content marketing plan based on the analytical information. All the changes, the continuous improvement that you do, that has to be data driven. Don't do any guesswork. Analyze the data from the analytics, go on doing the continuous improvement. And this is how the content marketing plan will work for you. And this is how you can actually set and achieve your objectives as far as your content marketing is concerned. Now, there are certain steps that you actually need to implement as far as your objectives are concerned. There are six steps that are outlined here. Number one is build user-friendly website and the landing page. The first and the foremost point when you actually think of doing content marketing, have a website that is responsive, have a website that is landing page that is responsive, that is completely optimized, and track an improvement, do the tracking and the improvement to the continuously to the website and the landing pages. We were talking about continuous improvement for the content marketing. The continuous improvement has also been there for your website or the landing pages that you are building. Go on improving the user interface, user experience, the usability factors, the images, all have to be completely user friendly. Then go for formulate and the beneficial content. The content that is going to be implemented on your websites, on the landing pages, even on the blogs. The content has to be completely focused on the end user. Identify, reach the targeted customers. The more you identify, the more you narrow down on your targeted customer, you will be able to reach them better. The more you quickly you reach them, you generate leads and the conversions happen. Then understand, engage, and target the customers. When you identify the targeted customers, you need to identify and engage with the targeted customer to know what are their requirements, listen to them, engage with them, interact with them so that you can understand them better and you will be able to provide a better solution. Drive conversions and build relationships. These are extremely important points. When you actually identify the customer, you understand the customer, you engage the customer, you provide solutions, that actually helps you in driving conversions and building relationship. And these are the key six key elements as far as your content objectives are concerned. Now, some of the best practices that you can implement as far as your objectives are concerned, research and brainstorm on content ideas. The more you research and understand the content ideas, the better for you. This is the first and foremost point. Determine content types. What kind of content that you actually need to publish? It could be text-based content, the infographics, the videos, the audios, the podcasts, the various types of content that you can actually create. Identify what kind of need to be published on which platform, on which media channel. Disseminate quality content. When you identify, when you research, when you create the content, when you curate the content, then actually go on disseminating, spreading the content to create the awareness. Build thought leadership. When you actually provide high value content, the content that actually provides the benefits to the end user, that solves a problem, then you will be identified as a thought leader in a particular niche on the industry. This is an extremely important point that builds brands for you. Less me and more about you. The more you talk about the customer, the less about yourself in the content, the better for you. Let's take an example. I say, I provide excellent content marketing techniques and services to you. That is not going to work. That is not the way. I provide the content marketing services for you that will help your business grow, that will make money for you. You're talking about the customer's point of view, and that is how the content has to be written. Subtle marketing. Content marketing never works when you actually go on hard selling. Hard selling will never work. It has to be subtle. It has to be persuasive. First listen, interact, engage, communicate, then go for the conversions. Create brand identity. Extremely important. When you actually build the high value content, you are considered a thought leader in the industry, that creates brand loyalty for you. Engage and build relationship. When you do all this, you actually engage and build relationship, lasting relationship with your customers. In conclusion, what we have seen in this video is how to set and achieve the objectives, six steps to content objectives, and what are the best practices you can think implementing as far as achieving your objectives are concerned. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you again.